we have somebody who is a system administrator currently, and they want to know which approach they should take to get AWS certified. Should they start with the solutions architect or the SysOps associate? So we have you guys are certified in both. What do you guys think as a system administrator? Which one is a good starting point?
I always like to say, you can correct me if you don't agree. I always like to recommend people to start with the Solutions Architect certification, because then to get certified in the other certifications will be much easier, because the Solutions Architect covers as a broad overview of all services, and it will cover very well how to really architect and solution using the best practices and cost-effective solutions. So that's really a great starting point. And the SysOps exam is by far the toughest exam of all the associate ones. And I'll say now, it's the toughest exam I ever took. So it's a long journey to achieve the SysOps certification. You need to have a lot of hands-on practice, and might be frustrating to start with that particular certification, because sometimes you can, who haven't ever failed an exam? It sucks. It's a day that you finish the exam and you see the result in the screen and you fail, and everything else sucks. You just want to go to your house and buy a big bucket of ice cream, eat some chocolates, and so that might be frustrating, and you might end up not motivated enough to keep trying to achieve that certification. So I think that would be halfway taking the solutions architect, and then the other halfway taking the SysOps.
I totally agree with you, Eric. Like you say, it'll be great to have a good understanding of services across the board and how they kind of interact with each other before looking at the SysOps, because like we discussed earlier, that kind of digs deeper into each service and a deeper level than the solutions architect does. So to have that broader knowledge first, I think it certainly helps when trying to get the SysOps, especially when it comes to troubleshooting. Although their current role is more guided to the SysOps, as an approach to the certification, I would recommend doing the solutions architect first and then the systems operations. So I completely agree.
I would say even more, if you really want the SysOps, after the solutions architect, take the developer one, because that will also help you getting the SysOps certification. Because in the developer one, you be aware of things such as managing sessions when you're using auto-scaling behind an ELB, and will be also another small step to the SysOps certification.
There's definitely overlap between the certifications as well, because when I was preparing for my solutions architect, I looked at the sample questions across all three associate exams, because if you look on the AWS website, they give you a few sample questions for each exam. And in my actual Solutions Architect associate exam, I got a couple of questions from each area that were on those sample exams online. So it's well worth having a look at all three, because there's definitely overlap between the three. So